What am I supposed to do with that? It looked like a termite just had a heyday there. It had like Thanksgiving and Christmas all in one. Like termite heaven. We're back at White Oak Manor and it's day 5 of the reception hall. We woke up to super chilly temperatures this morning, but this venue has to be ready by springtime, so we have no choice but to move forward. So let's get to it and make it happen, Captain. I'm glad I switched to the Sprinter van. We were able to buy one of these things because there is at least one of everything in that thing. You need a marker, you need a can of spray paint, use that Illyrio. What do you need? You got it. First time I've ever driven one of these, and we're just gonna move it a little bit so that way all of his different sizes are accessible. Hey, look at that. That's the first time I ever drove a Bobcat.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, man, I even figured out how to crank it up. That's not bad. While we're getting some more of this sheeting going on, Illyrio is gonna go ahead and start the construction of the center portion of the walls. Now those are gonna be about 18 feet tall and we're really unsure of exactly how we want to attack it. So we're gonna try one scenario, see if it works out good for us, and if it's a go, it's a go. But we think we're gonna lay it down, frame it all up on the floor, and then we'll just try to stand it up with the crane. It's looking good, looking real good. When I build those walls up top, I'm gonna build them a little bit out, streamline it from end to end, and we're gonna make it straight as possible. Yep. Same thing here, same thing with the roof. It's just how it's gonna be. It's gonna be that rustic look, and it's gonna be different size beams, because you know what? That's what they are. See, I didn't know this until yesterday. I was wondering why Alex was always in that skid steer all day long. Then I finally got in it. There is a super energized heat system in that thing. It's so toasty, it's probably about 98 degrees inside of that thing right now. He's just loving life.
Where do we want to fit this stuff at?
I don't know, but you get, it's kind of nice inside there, isn't it, bud?
It's all right in there.
You got a little heat in there?
A little cold as well.
What am I supposed to do with that? It looked like a termite just had a heyday there. It had like Thanksgiving and Christmas all in one. Like termite heaven. I'm gonna go show him. From what he brought us yesterday, we got about 200 linear foot of the 5-inch and 3-inch pieces that is just absolutely not usable, which is understandable, but it's gotta be, you know, tit for tat. We can only pay for what we can use. If you bring us stuff that's completely damaged, I mean, I've got 12-foot pieces that absolutely don't even have a tongue on it with no way to even lock into the previous sheet. So, you know, what's got to be good for the goose needs to be good for the gander as well. Well, I'll tell you what, I've been in that serrano pepper that you brought me last night. Boy, I regret it. Now I know what you must have got.
Finally caught the hot
one. I caught the hot one last night, and Nancy's like, well, I think that was a little hot. I'm like, no, them peppers aren't hot.
Yeah.
I bit that sucker, instantly just yellow jackets in my mouth. Ah! My sister's bringing me cups of milk. I got water, milk, tortillas. I'm just trying to calm it down with whatever I can. It didn't work. So we figured out what was going on with the walls being different measurements. Good thing is we built our walls perfectly level. But that uppermost post up there, they forgot to do the notch. And that's what was throwing off our measurements. Good thing is we'll stand this thing up, tie it into that post, tie it into that post, and then we'll be able to leave that 2x4 on the outermost side, and I'll cut that notch with a chainsaw. You know, maybe put a temporary support underneath of it, cut it with a chainsaw, and drop it down to the correct height. As long as all these beams are within an eighth or a quarter of an inch, I can make it work with some rips and leveling this thing out before we set those big steel trusses. But what I don't want to do is be up there trying to manipulate heights with 4,000 pound trusses on top of me. But I think if we take a little time today before we set trusses, I think we'll be good to go. The frost is coming off the roof rather quickly. It's about 10 o'clock, so it's worked really well. We'll just continue on with these couple walls, and once we get them up, it should lend itself to letting us get back on there and continue the sheathing of that lower shed roof. So hopefully we can get that vapor barrier on today and protect it from any more freezing and frost over these night periods. It's getting down to about 20 degrees. So we'll just take those two straps, put it on similarly to what we did with the rafters, try to pick it up from two points of pressure. And I think just as you come up, we'll just let it fall down into that slot. I'm gonna be real excited when this is over. I just want it to go well, get it up. It's really gonna provide support from that side and transfer it all the way over to this side. And then I'll be able to run a string line down and finalize these braces before we start working on this front porch area. And block him off so he don't go too far. Keep that tension. Keep that tension going up. I need you to extend the boom out now. Don't lower it no more. Just extend it out. Try to keep that cable at the same tension. All right, Kevin, nail me down to the bottom. All right, can you extend it out a little bit more? There we go. Yeah, all the way down. One up, one to go. You ever seen, you know who Michael J. Fox is? Well, he also did the movie where he is called Teen Wolf.
Yeah, I know.
I think what we got out there is not Teen Wolf, but it's called Middle-Aged Wolf.
Yeah.
But when every time you look at Chip for the rest of the day, just call him Middle-Aged Wolf. And we got a name for you. Middle-aged wolf.
Wait till you see me Sunday. Sunday, come Sunday.
And not Teen Wolf like Michael J. Fox. Oh, we're calling middle-aged root wolf. You're 44 years old, Chip.
No, I'm 42.
Okay, 42.
Hey,
you ain't even middle-aged yet.
It's for my football game, bro. I'm cornrowing it, and I'm coloring them silver and black.
Oh, really? This Chip's got such a good head start on us now. By cutting all those nominal numbers for us with that poplar wood, I think some of those members are about 12'7", 12'4", 12'5", whatever the case may be, but neither side is squared up. So he's able to cut all those pieces square, get ahead of us so that when we do start running, we won't have to wait for the cut man to keep up with us. So we'll get this wall up. It'll lend us to be able to sheath the outside of these while we continue to advance that up. And then hopefully at the end of the day today, we can start working on the placement of these metal plates and the construction of this porch beams and post. If we get that far, I'll feel like it's one of our most productive days yet. So we're just picking up steam as we keep going on this thing. Pull this down, get it about halfway, and then pull it tight. hopefully this one goes smooth just like that one did. We did a really good job of leveling off those big posts. We didn't even have to move that brace to get the wall up, and it just went in there nice and snug. This part makes me nervous. As long as we don't hear no crazy crackling and popping, we should be good. Keep on going like you're going, bud. Just keep on going. Well, that was the possibility. Just keep going all the way up. Go all the way up. And then keep the cable coming up. Keep it coming back. Right there. Ho. Give me a little bit back. A little bit back. Watch your tails, Romeo. Just get up there and bang it with your hand until I can get flush. A little bit more, a little bit more. Gosh, I must have leveled them semi-decent. It's your fit. It was tight. That didn't go as smooth as the first one.
It didn't. But it's in there.
But it's in there, baby. And we didn't have to move either one of those towers. Almost like we're building a Roman structure or something. I feel like we're working with stone mortars. 20,000 pounds, move it with no one man. Poplar wood that Alex has shipped in, but every row is a different measurement. So we have some 5-inch pieces, some 6-inch pieces, 7s, and then even up to here, you'll see some 3.5s or 3. So we're kind of mixing this in so it's not all one in a row. There's no real pattern, but pretty much every 2 rows is 6 inches, being that that's what we have the most of. And then we're mixing in some 5s, 7s, and 3s in there periodically. But this is V-cut, tongue and groove, so it's gotta come real nice and tight together so that it makes that pretty V underneath and doesn't have any gaps. Now, it's gonna, of course, expand and contract, but it's coming out to a real nice fit, and man, this poplar wood looks beautiful. De un cinco. Yep. They need a piece pad too. What are these right here?
These are
3.5s?
Yeah.
What are these?
6s.
6s. All right, I'm gonna get this off then. And then I'm gonna grab both of these and take them around there. I'm gonna pick these two up. Then I want you to grab these real quick and move them off. Okay. Man, I don't care who you are, that never gets old. When he brought the first order in for this side of the lean-to shed, he brought some really nice stuff. 12-foot links really worked out with our 4-foot layout. But on the secondary package that he brought in this morning, everything's 8 and 10 foot. So we literally got 7 packs of wood that's 10 foot long and just doesn't work with our 4-foot on center layout. And if we cut it 8 foot to break on the center of the rafters, we're gonna lose about 500 square feet, and at $2.25 a square foot, that's $1,000, man. I can't do that, man. We're gonna have to figure out a better solution. I'll have to think about it for a minute. Golly, that sucks. glad when this tongue and groove's over. I know we got a lot more tongue and groove to go, but at least we're kind of breaking up the monotony a little bit. Once we finish this side, then we get to frame a little bit of normal stuff, and then back to tongue and groove. But this last day and a half on this roof right here has worn me out. I feel like I've done run about 5 miles, 100 foot, 50 foot, 50 foot, 50 foot, 50 foot. I am wore out. These old legs are pumping. Like that? All right, let's see if we can finish this thing. Oh. Hey, I tell you what, I'm stiff. I am wore out. We are getting there. It's getting chilly, Willie. We're running out of light today, guys, so we're gonna have to call it a wrap. My guys kicked it really hard today, and I feel like I might have too. So make sure you like and subscribe, and hit that notification bell if you haven't already. Until next time, y'all have a great day. I gotta get back to work. We made it, Rocky! We made it, Rocky! Yeah!